What's up, divas and divos? So you know it is Real Talk Wednesday with your girl April, and of course I am still rocking these clip-ins from Better Length Hair. I actually took them out for probably like 8 hours just to do some wig videos, and then I put them back in because a bitch get hot. It's like 116, 120 degrees out here. No lie, it is super hot. So right now I cannot do the wigs. I just can't. It's just so hot. And as bad as I want to look glamorous all the time, I need to breathe. I don't want to be outside and I just pass out and people are like, what happened to her? Did she have a heat stroke? No, bitch. It's because I got this goddamn wig on my head that feel like another fucking hat. So I am going to do the clip-ins for a while because it's just super hot. I like them a lot, especially since I flat ironed them. If you've seen my video, which was a huge epic fail, and then I fixed them because I had to flat iron them. They're actually kinky straight, but once I flat ironed them, they got to like this light yakky texture, which better blended with my own hair. So yes, I love them. I haven't taken initiative to curl them because it's just so much easier to wrap them or to wrap it at night. So I don't remove them. I leave them in my hair and I just wrap my hair and I put on a netted wig cap, and then I put on my bonnet. Just so much easier. When you curl them, it's kind of like, I just really don't feel like doing all the extra work. But yeah, so my day or my week has been really great. Yesterday was the actual, well, by the time you get this, it'll be 2 days later. So Monday was the actual first day of Bath & Body Works semi-annual sale. So if you ladies have not checked it out, please do so. They have lotions for half off or 75% off and half off. Candles for half off and candles for $12. $22.50 is a lot for one candle, so you can get one for $12 or you can get them for $11.25. Me, I'm super cheap, so I really went to the table where they were half off. 75 cents is not a lot, but I'd rather pay $11.25 versus the $12 candles. They're the same candles, different scents, but same size candles. Then they have lotions for $3.75. So yeah, shower gels, lotions, everything. So I spent probably like $200 on Bath & Body Works. I went to two different stores, and actually they're not all for me. I do have three daughters, so of course I do divvy them up and split them. But I will be at another Bath & Body Works. Probably tomorrow I'll go to this other one, because now I realize I only have like six shower gels left to myself, and like six lotions and four body sprays and whatever, and a bunch of candles. So anyway, yes, make sure you check out Bath & Body Works because they have their semi-annual sale. It's normally like a month, and each week they have a different sale, but the first week is always like awesome. So yes. So basically, that's just about it. As for my love life, still single and so happy. I have been just so overjoyed, and every day I'm just so thankful, and I thank God for just being single and taking that devil out of my home. And I'm not gonna really spend too much time on him, so if you haven't seen the video of Real Talk of my sudden breakup, make sure you check it out, and I will give you all the details there of what actually happened in that breakup. Yes, but I will tell you this, he is so petty, very, very much so petty, and a big, huge time liar. So yeah, it's one thing to be a liar or to be petty, but it's a second thing when you take their tablet and after you put them out the home and you see them with a Facebook message to some other chick, their other baby mama, and they fucking, like, how you gonna be fucking some bitch when you only last 3 minutes and your dick is like, anyway. So yeah, so anyway, if you want a real talk situation about yourself or some family members, neighbors, friends, what have you, go ahead and send me an email to muffinismylovers2012@gmail.com. Please put in the subject line Real Talk, and if you want to change the names, please mention that in the beginning of the email so that way I don't think of any off-the-wall landish names that pop up off the top of my head. But yeah, I'm not gonna have a drink today because I already had one, if you probably can tell. And I've got this cute little straw from the dollar store. It's like a little pink flamingo, really, really cute. So yeah, I had like, I guess they call them screwdrivers because it's just vodka and orange juice. There goes that. And yeah, and also, okay, so I got this kit. Okay, I don't really know if black girls try this out, but I'm gonna be the first black girl to try this out if they haven't. This is by Pouty Lips. The Pouty Lips you always wanted, naturally. So you know that Kylie Jenner lip suction thing? Well, this one is like 10 times better. And first of all, it comes wrapped up in this cute box. And these to make your lips look fuller. So if you ever watch any of my makeup videos, you see that I use the Too Faced Extreme Lip Injection. That stuff really works, but not really works. So this one comes with this huge book of instructions and pamphlets, which is awesome. It tells you exactly how to use it, safety instructions, what have you. Super cute, gives you pictures of how your lips would look. So I'm really excited to try this out. And if you want to see this in a video alone or in a makeup video, let me know below by saying alone or in a makeup video and I will show you. But I just wanted to show you the product firsthand. Yes, I'm going to use these because, okay, I am black, but if you guys can tell, I really don't have much top lip. So this is what their packaging looks like. Really cute. Candy Lips is what it's called. And this is the top where you would just keep it on, keep it sanitized. And right here is where you would actually put your lips. So depending on how you want your lips to be shaped, they have molds to go through it. So it comes in a cute satchel with a tassel bag. And these are the molds that come with it. So say you wanted a crease in your bottom lip like Angelina Jolie, you would use Moldy. And it shows you everything in the packaging. This right here is the actual jelly mount mold, which you would put on top of this so your lips don't get like that harsh ring. And yes, super duper cute. I did try it out somewhat last night, but I'm going to read the instructions furthermore so I don't come on here and look like I got a infection or a bee sting in my mouth. So I'm really excited about this. It's squeezable, and yeah, so like I said, if you want to see this in a video just alone, then leave your comments below, or if you want to see the makeup video, let me know. But either way, this is by Candy Lips, and I will post their information for you girls below. So if you got those thin paper ass thin lips and you want them to look so juicy, who doesn't want nice full lips? Like, I freaking am so envious of the girls that have nice full lips. Like my eldest daughter, Tatiana, she has like the perfect lips. Oh my God. I think like the perfect lips sometimes are perfect for lipsticks and stuff, like certain colors. You know what I mean? That's probably why it's really hard for me to put on red lipstick sometimes, because I don't really don't have much going on up here. Not much. Yeah. So anyway, so let's get on to this real talk. If you want a unit, a wig made by myself, I do have like one left. I sold like this one Russian straight virgin unit yesterday with a silk-based closure. Oh my God. It really took tooth and nails out of me to get rid of it, but I was like, you know what? It's so fucking pretty, but it's so hot out here. I can't do this until like the end of October. And for all that, let's just pass. So yeah, so if you want a custom unit made by me, you can always check out my website, which I will link below, which is goingwiththewindwigs.webly.com, as well as that, as I do have in-stock units, video units. They do sell out really, really fast, so just keep checking frequently. But yeah, you can check out my website. So yes, let's get on to this real talk, y'all. Here it says urgent, please help, and it's not as long as the last one that I read from last week, but yeah, this is a doozy. So let's begin. Hi April, I will try to make this short and to the point. You can call me Tia. I'm a single 40-year-old woman, mom, one child, 9 years old, living with my mom for the past year because of the cost of living here in New York City is high. So basically, she lives with her mother, and she has a child who is 9 years old, and they live in New York City because the cost of living is high. And we all know this. I definitely know this. We sleep in the living room, and it's so embarrassing, but it's for my child. It has been very hard for us. At one point, we were in a shelter, but I always kept my job, 17 years employed. Here's the thing. Last year, December, I met this Peruvian man, 38 years old, no kids. I am black. He could hardly speak English, but asked me to go have breakfast with him. We exchanged numbers. I called, but it kept ringing. Saw him again, and he said, let's go breakfast. Trying hard to speak English. I said, I tried to call your phone, but it just rang. He said, I will call you. Next day, nothing. He never called. Saw him again, and he said, I called you. I said, all I got was a private number, missed call. I don't answer private numbers. Why are you calling me private? Then he says, I have a situation, a lady at home. I want kids. I am not happy. So I told him, I don't get involved in situations like that. When you're out of that situation, then we can talk. He said, okay, can we still talk? I said, no. A month passes, and he sees me and says, I'm done with her. I moved out, left New Jersey, and got my own place in Queens. I said, okay, that's nice. Then he asked me out again. We went out once, then I decided to back off because I knew he just got out of a relationship. I stayed away from him for a month. We went out again, got along great. His English started to improve. He said he never dated a black woman and liked our culture, music, etc. He enrolled in a language school, works during the day. He is a very hard worker and also has four people working for him in a cleaning business besides his own job. One day, I get a phone call from a Spanish woman saying hello on my voicemail. I had 3 missed calls from her. When I called back, she wouldn't answer, so I sent a text message. She responded saying, wrong number. I asked Jose, his name is changed, do you know this woman? He said, yes. She took my phone one day at my uncle's house. We were drinking. I said, why would a woman do that unless you were sleeping with her? I told him, I am too old for a woman to be calling my phone. He said he spoke to her and told her that was wrong. Never found out what she had to tell me. Weeks pass, we're dating. Then one day I go to his house. I see a woman hairbrush. I ask, whose brush is this? He says, I don't know. I looked at him like he was stupid. Then I looked again and I see a woman's eyeliner pencil. Shaking my head. Then he says the brush was in the boxes when he packed and left New Jersey. And the eyeliner pencil as well. He found it in the street. So he found the eyeliner pencil in the street and he thought it was a pen. So now I'm saying to myself, this man is a liar. But he tells me, baby, I'm telling you the truth. You don't trust me? My ex didn't trust me. This caused problems. I said, you had a woman call my phone, a brush and makeup? Yes, I'm going to question that. So I let it go because we just were together 3.5 months. 3.5 months in a new relationship. Here's the problem, April. We're talking on the phone about if we are together in the future. We're going to have a baby next year. He even said, do you see me as your husband? Talked about our businesses. He have his and I want to start a little side business. He continued to talk. Then I heard the word divorce. I said, what? What you say? He said, we separated. I live alone. She in New Jersey. I said, what? Why are you just telling me this? He said, you never asked. I said, yes, I did, and would never have dated him if I knew he was married. He says, I left New Jersey. I don't want to go back. She has called me to come back. I am happy. I don't want to, and I will be filing for divorce when 12 months is up. He says she was always at her family's house. He says she was always at her family's house. She never cooked, and he ate out every day, come in late, and then he would get up early for work. She would be sleeping, then stay in the bed until 11 a.m. she would. April, I was so crushed. I really like this man, and I would never date a married man. I was so set on not dealing with him anymore, but he has become my friend as well. April, this man treats me better than any man I have ever met. He takes me out, pays for everything. Sex is so good. He texts me every morning, tells me my child will be his child in the future. He will love as his own. Okay, so he will love her child as his own. By the way, he hasn't met my child yet. He opens doors for me, works hard 7 days a week. He tells me I'm a good woman and he wants to be with me. He is happy with me. I had a really bad relationship in the past and I admire our friendship and we like being around each other. April, do I stay and date this married man? Please help me. So first of all, Tia is 40 years old. She's a single mom. She has a 9-year-old. She lives at home with her own mother in New York City because of the cost of living. Her and her 9-year-old sleep on a couch in the living room, basically. They sleep in the living room. And she's met some Peruvian man who is 38 years old. He is married and was living in New Jersey. He has no kids, and he says he's not happy, and he has moved from New Jersey to Queens. What's up, Queens? Because that's where I'm from. But he never told her he was married until just recently. And is talking about this. So they're talking about having kids together and getting married and talking about the future. Tia, are you fucking blind? Like, I'm sorry. But bitch, you 40 years old. I know I might have had a glass of liquor, but I'm not drunk, okay? You 40 years old. What 40-year-old motherfucker, black woman, I don't really care what color you are, what race you are, what 40-year-old woman wants to have a baby? Like, seriously, I'm about to be 42 on Father's Day, June 19th, okay? Gemini in the house. I'm sorry, but if I was to end up getting pregnant, first of all, I'm not ended up getting pregnant. But at 40 years old, you should not be really thinking about having a baby with some foreigner who barely speaks fucking English. 9 times out of 10, bitch, he wanna marry your ass and he's sweet talking you into the pussy in the motherfucking bed because he probably don't have a green card. I'm just saying because my stepmother, she is Philippine and she speaks really good English. I would say on a scale of 1 to 10, her English skills are about a 7.5, okay? And I'm pretty sure she speaks better than your Peruvian man. And she doesn't have her, what do you call those? Oh God, I was about to say immunization papers. But you know what I'm saying? When you get those citizenship, she doesn't have her citizenship from America yet. She went and took the test and she failed, okay? Because of certain questions, they ask like these really weird questions now. Either way, she speaks damn good English better than your boyfriend does, and I'm pretty sure he don't have citizenship. Because if he has some type of citizenship, I'm pretty sure his English will be a whole lot better. You gotta learn to speak good English, or not even 100% good English, but you gotta learn to speak a decent amount of English and to know how to vocabularize, or if that's even a fucking word. You just need to articulate. And he really doesn't seem like he's articulating that great to be a citizen. So in my own personal opinion, I really feel like he's just trying to fuck with you so you can become his wife and he can get citizenship here. You know what I'm saying? You're looking vulnerable to him because for one, you sleep at home on your mother's living room sofa or whatever have you. And I'm not judging you, but here's the thing. You're 40 years old. You've just got out of a bad relationship. But the main key is you're 40 years the fuck old. You have a 9-year-old kid. You live at home with your mother. Why would you even be thinking about dating a freaking person that barely can speak English? Have you asked him, does he have a green card? Have you even bothered to ask him, does he have citizenship? Okay? Has that come up in the fucking conversation? Is he a citizen? Because if he tells you no, then you need to fucking backtrack, flashback, side think the shit, and question the motherfucker. Well, I just found out you was married. Are you a motherfucking citizen? Now see, these motherfuckers that ain't from the United States, and I'm not fucking judging anybody that ain't from here because that's your business, but there are a lot of them that come here to find a wife, a vulnerable ass woman in your situation that they prey on, okay? So yeah, oh, she lives at home with her mother and she has a child. All I gotta do is say the right fucking things and I can get it real good with her. I can move her into my apartment in Queens and then I can get citizenship from marrying her. That's the easy route. And unfortunately, it's females like you that have just come out of a bad relationship. And the first nice fucking thing that a man says to you, you fall head over heels and you melt like ice cream sitting out on the back porch on a fucking Arizona 120 degree day. Okay, now, I'm sorry, babies are a blessing. I'm 41 years old, okay? I have 2 grandkids, one that's 3.5 and one that's 1.5, and they're both boys. They're enough for me that I don't need no kids of my own. I'd be damned if I got pregnant right here about now. I would probably jump off of my bedroom balcony and try to kill myself if I ended up pregnant at the age of 41 going on 42 years old. I mean, there's a time limit to things, and I'm not saying that you're too old to have a baby, but you're too old for the bullshit. It is time to enjoy your life and get on your own 2 feet. Why the fuck would you be even talking about having a baby with somebody that you've been with for 3.5 months? Isn't that a fucking red flag? I wish a motherfucker would be dating me for 3.5 months and be talking about a baby. I would slap the shit out of him and then be like, you know what? I can't fuck with you no more. We ain't about to have no babies. I barely am making ends meet and now you talking about having a baby? 40 years old. You're 40 years old. Okay, I'm 41. I got 2 fucking years on you. 42. I'm about to be 42. I don't want any more kids. I've had my fair share of kids. I have 5 kids and 2 grandkids. And trust and believe that 1 kid is enough. If you live at home with your mother because it's rough times, what makes you fucking think that this man is going to really be there and do some shit for you and you're having a baby at 40 years old? 41, because you have to be pregnant for 40 weeks, which is actually 10 months. So you might be almost 41. So let's just round it off and you'll have a baby at like the age of 42 and 43. Like really, who does that? That's not logical thinking. At that time in your life, that age peak, me personally, because I'm only 42, almost 42 years old, I'm not trying to find a fucking babysitter. for a newborn. And I'm really not trying to get up and change nobody's fucking diaper. Now, let me tell you something. I watch my grandson when my daughter goes to work, and I enjoy the time with him because that's my Tinky man, and I love him to death. You know what I'm saying? But do I want to have a baby at 41, 42 years old? Hell fucking no. It's time for me to enjoy life. My youngest is about to be 9 years old, and she's still a baby to me because she's nine. I cannot just walk out the house and leave her here by herself because she's only nine. You know what I'm saying? So somewhat, I have my eldest daughter watch her, or my other kids that's in the house watch her, but I cannot just leave her. You know what I'm saying? And she's nine. And if I really wanted to go away for a few days, of course, I have to make arrangements for her. Thank God I have a kid that's 20 and 18 years old that, you know what I'm saying, that are in Arizona. My 18-year-old that lives with me, my 20-year-old that's here. You know what I'm saying? I'm thankful for that. But you have a 9-year-old. You have. Your oldest is 9. You have one fucking kid. Do you really think your 9-year-old is going to be able to watch your motherfucking baby? Your 9-year-old will be like 10 and 11. You really think that your 9, 10, 11-year-old is going to be able to watch your newborn? Do you really fucking think so? I'm like, really, Tia? Let's just fucking open your brain up and your mind up. And I'm not trying to come at you hard like that, but let's just think rational. What the fuck should you do? You need to ask him, does he have citizenship? So what? He's treated you nice. He opens doors for you. He's pulled your chair out. He pays for stuff. The sex is great. Okay, you know what? The sex can be great. That's nice and dandy. But how long does it fucking last? Is it a lifetime of pure blissfulness and commitment and truthfulness? Because sex can last 3 motherfucking minutes. And 3 minutes ain't shit, okay? Hello? Until 3 minutes of fucking pleasure ain't shit to fucking 9 and 10 months of pure agony, or living with somebody that you truly end up hating because you realize at the end that they only fucking used you for having citizenship. Of course he should open the doors. Of course he should pull his chairs out. Of course he should pay for shit. And of course the sex should be great. He's a man. That is what he's supposed to do. You know what I'm saying? Don't act like he's the only gentleman in the motherfucking world that has something to give and bring to the table. This is temporarily, because I guarantee you he probably doesn't have citizenship. And you're the vulnerable bitch that he sees, that he has his eyes on like a radar, and is like, you know what? Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Her, I gotta pay. Just because he's a Peruvian and he barely speaks any fucking English doesn't mean that he's not a con artist and he don't know how to swindle you out of your motherfucking panties and off your motherfucking feet to get you and use you and marry you for citizenship. That's not because of he doesn't speak good English, because he knows he's a fucking man. He's a fucking man, and this is what they do. Like, okay, here's the thing. You're 40 years old. I would think you would know better by now. With the email that you sent me, you're acting like you're 10. Or you're acting like a teenager that just got into a relationship and you're fucking head over heels. You know the first time we're teenagers and we fall in love and we're like, oh my God, he's so cute. I'm going to marry him. We're going to have kids together. We're going to be together forever. And you're writing things on your little notebook. I love Jimmy and I love Joseph and I love Jose. And we're going to be together forever. And you're sending little notes and shit like that. And then, like, in college, you're like, he's a fucking asshole. Or you just moved on. That's how you're acting, like a fucking high school, college student that just got into a new relationship. I get it. You're fucking lonely and you want to be with someone and you got out of a bad relationship. But here's the thing. Like I've said in several fucking videos, find yourself. Search your soul. When you get out of a bad relationship, it doesn't mean jump into the next one. That's when you're most... Okay, like I was saying before, my memory card got full. I had to put the other one in. When you got out of a bad relationship, that's when you're, like, most vulnerable. What the fuck? Why would you want to get into another relationship? You know what? I'm not saying be alone like me. You know something? I'm going to be just honest like this. Being alone doesn't necessarily always mean being the fuck alone. You just need, honestly, some time to find for yourselves. Like, I can't stand to see women like, oh, my God. I have to find a man because I just broke up with somebody. Like, I don't really get it. Like, who does that? Like, okay, nobody wants to be alone for the rest of their life, but damn, bitch, won't you give it a break? You just got finished fucking this nigga like 2 weeks ago. Now you ready for a new relationship? That's why your last one didn't fucking work out, because you just didn't give it time. And like, you know, somebody just asked me recently that I know, like, you don't miss him, meaning my ex that I just got rid of. You don't miss him. You don't be alone. I was like, what, bitch? Did I just fucking tell you what the fuck happened? You gonna ask me some dumbass shit like that? You know what I'm saying? This is what I said to her. You gonna ask me some dumbass shit like that? Do I miss him? Hell fucking no, I don't miss him. When he fucking got taken out of here, I was like, yes. I was been wanting him to fucking go. No, I don't fucking miss him. And I'm not lonely because I have my children. I might not have that companionship of being kissed on and being fucking licked on and touched on. But you know what? I have the type of fucking sentimental value of myself that I don't have to be fucking ridiculed, humiliated, told what to do, asked where the fuck you at, and bothered with the bullshit and stress the fuck out. Like, no, I don't miss him, okay? Oh, I just really couldn't be alone. Well, then that's the fucking problem with you, because you just can't be alone. And it's so pathetic when you see women that just really can't be the fuck alone for a certain amount of time because they so hard up for some motherfucking dick or to be in a relationship with somebody. Like I said, it's very nice to be in a relationship with somebody and to have companionship and to be loved on. However, don't you think that you should fucking know yourself and know your worth before you even get into a relationship like that? So that way you know what and what not to put up with. Because if you don't, then bitch, you're gonna be putting up with any fucking thing. And just like with this fucking Jose character right here, I guarantee you he probably doesn't have citizenship and he's looking at you like a fucking red Target. And I don't mean the fucking Target that you can go in with your red shopping cart and buy some fucking outfits and makeup from. I'm talking about you are a red Target to him. He has his eyes on the prey. You're like the fucking little animal in the jungle and he's one of those beasts, okay? He's gonna jump on you and pounce on you, get in good, and then once he's gotten in good, he's gonna pop the question. You're gonna get married to him and he's gonna get his citizenship and then he's gonna start treating you like shit. Why is he not happy with the lady that he's in New Jersey with? This is the problem with motherfuckers. It doesn't matter what their race and ethnicity is. They always talk shit about their ex-girlfriends to the next bitch. Oh, she was always at her family's house like he told you. She never cooked dinner. Okay, right, and et cetera, et cetera. Just like the motherfucker that I just got rid of when he told his baby mother who he was fucking around on me. Oh, that ugly fat bitch. Oh, she always wanted to have sex with me, but I wouldn't have sex with her. I slept on the couch. I didn't even want her like that. First of all, I'm not tooting my own motherfucking horn, but I'm not fucking ugly, okay? I know this for a fact. And I might not be fucking skinny. I'm not fat, I'm plus size, and I have a shape, and I think I look damn motherfucking good. And as for sex, nigga, I was coming up with excuses upon excuses not to have sex with him. It's so bad when you coming up with excuses, like, by the end of the night, I would be getting sick, like, oh, my allergies are killing me. This is the type of shit I would say. I had my period for, like, 2 weeks straight. And that's just, like, unrealistic, but you know what I'm saying? Like, and sleep on the couch. I wish the motherfucker would sleep on the couch. Because one of my living rooms has a nice pull-out couch, which is very comfy. And he was more than welcome to it. But the nigga never slept on the couch, okay? Never. So, this is the bullshit that they tell to their new girlfriends or to the bitch that they fucking with when they got caught. So, if you want to go ahead and believe everything he says, then go ahead and be one of those dumb teenagers in high school that just got into a relationship. You didn't even know he was married. You sleep at home at your mother's house. You and your son, your 9-year-old son, live with your mother, which is nothing wrong with that. I'm trying to get my mother, who is 62, to move from Queens to Arizona with me because she needs to. But, yeah, if I was living with my mom at the age of 40, I would not be thinking about getting married to some fucking foreign man that barely could speak English, talking about having a baby, and he's gonna love my child like his own, and he moved from New Jersey, and he's not with her, that's fucking married. Should you get with the married man? Everybody has a situation. You could be with a married man, that's fine, and I'm not saying that a married man that lives at home with his wife and he's cheating on her. Maybe a married man that's separated and is on the verge of getting divorced, okay, that might be acceptable. However, this motherfucker is not acceptable, okay? Non-exempt, he's not acceptable to the fucking issue at hand. The motherfucker probably doesn't have a green card. So, yeah. At 40 years old, Tia, let's think about other things besides having kids. Like, let's say, getting another job. You've been at the same job for 17 years, and you live at home with your mom. So, it may not even have to do with getting another job. Maybe moving out on your own and spreading your wings and learning how to fly. Like, you know that old song, one of my faves, and I'm pretty sure you can relate to that, Tia, because you're my age. Spread my wings and fly away. Like, troop, troop, you know the troop. Listen to that. Stop thinking and worrying about a fucking man and worry about you and your son and you and your son's future versus he, Jose, and your future. I'm sorry, but if he can barely speak English, I'm really trying not to deal with you, because you could be calling me a bitch for all I fucking know. I mean, so yeah, like, if I came across as being a little harsh, then it's real talk. What the fuck do you expect? Let's move on to the next one. Because that one right there kind of pissed me off at the age of 40. Why would you be thinking about having fucking kids with somebody you just met? Anyway, so this one she previously sent on February 17th. And I'm so sorry, honey, if I did not get back to you. So let's read this. Hey, April, I wanted to email you on behalf of your opinion about my mother's longtime boyfriend. We can call... Wait a minute, is her name Tia too? Wow, this is like so fucking crazy, because the young lady in the first one is like, you can call me Tia. That's 40 years old. And then this one here, she's like, you can call me Tia. And her boyfriend, I guess you say Cole, K-O-L-E, Cole? We're not going to call you Tia, because I just used Tia. We're going to call you Natalie. Okay, so, hey, April, I wanted to email you on behalf of your opinion about my mother's longtime boyfriend. We can call myself Natalie and her boyfriend Cole. I think that's how you say it. Here is some backstory. My parents were married, then got divorced when I was in the second grade. I actually met this guy, Cole, one day as my mom's friend when my parents were still married. After the divorce was final, Cole started coming around frequently. From the very first time I saw this guy, I didn't care for him. I have this instinct where when I initially meet a person, I could tell if I care for them or not. She sounds like me. Couple past events happened to where my instincts were proven correct. Stole money from my room, and I'm a preteen age, and always was known to steal money from my mother's purse. He always had a tendency to influence my mother on what to say, act towards me, and try to act like he was my dad. Cole eats up most groceries possibly in sight, drives my mother's car, etc. I'm afraid that my mother is just keeping him around for some manly attention and handyman fix-it purposes. My mother is in her mid-50s, and I honestly don't think this man loves my mother. He just loves that she's being his sugar mother. I'm currently 21 and living with my mother, and Cole is defiantly still in the picture. By the way, I've never known him to have a car, house, or job. He lives with his mother, and he's in his early 50s. I can tell that he sometimes stresses my mom out. April, please tell me your opinion about the situation, and what outcome do you see happening? Will she leave, or will he leave? Will this forever go on? Thanks. Damn. So first of all, Natalie, you're 21, and your parents got divorced in the second grade, and Cole has been coming around. You've met him as a friend when your parents were still married. So you're 21. This motherfucker's been around for some time, and now they both in their 50s. Are you telling me that this motherfucker don't got a job, and he's 50-something years old and lives at home with his mother? God damn. Okay, let's talk about this. Okay, at 50 years old, you should not be living with your motherfucking parents. If your parents are ill and need help, then they should be living with you, okay? You, not you, living with your parents. He doesn't have a job. He doesn't have a car. I'm pretty sure he ain't getting retirement, because you have yet to see him have a job in all that time frame. How the fuck does somebody survive all this time with not having a job, living at the home with their own parent? Like, who the fuck does this? And you know something, Natalie? You might just be right. At the age of 50, some women feel like, oh, they ain't got it no more. They're going to settle for whatever. But basically, they have been friends and hitting and humping around for quite some time now, okay? Since you've been in the second grade. And prior to that, probably like in the first grade when you first met him as her friend. So this has been going on some time. I don't really give a fuck what type of handyman fixer-upper you can do. Motherfucker, if you don't have no job, why the fuck do you need to borrow my car? And how are you putting gas in it if you don't have a job? And on top of that, I find it very unattractive when a man does not have his own shit. At 50 years old, you're living with your mother still. What is his mom, like 80 something? Is he waiting for her to die and take everything that she has? Like, it just seems like a relationship where it's a convenience to me. You know what I'm saying? Is this going to go on forever? It probably is. Your mother's in her 50s, and he's in his 50s, and he's living at home with his mother still. As long as she allows him to drive her car and eat up the motherfucking groceries. Now, that is one thing that I cannot stand. And you know what I'm saying? Like, I have 5 kids and 2 grandkids. But when I go grocery shopping, I go grocery shopping. And I cannot stand for my kids to start rummaging through the cabinets as soon as the groceries are put away, because that is a form of gluttony. You only want it because you see it. You weren't thinking about that shit hours ago before it was even here. That's a form of gluttony, okay, which is one of a sin. It's a sin, okay? That's a sin. And here's the thing, Cole, and it's probably the reason why she probably called him Cole is from Martin and Gina. When Cole used to come over, be in the refrigerator all the time, barely had a job, had that old ass lady as his girlfriend, was using her car and everything else, and lived with his mama. That's probably the main reason why she's calling him Cole. Okay, and if you guys remember Martin Lawrence Show, Martin and Gina, I'm pretty sure you guys know what I'm talking about. And that's probably why she named him Cole. Is it going to go on forever? Well, let's just see this. Say this. Your mother's in her 50s, and she's probably quite comfortable with the situation. Have you ever taken the time, Natalie, to sit down and talk with your mother about this gentleman caller who is just sitting around eating up your motherfucking groceries, driving your mother's car, and living at home with his own mother at the age of 50? Have you ever sat there and said to your mom, listen, I love you with all my heart because you're my mother and I care for you dearly, and I would never want to see you hurt and taken advantage of, but what do you really think the outcome of this relationship with you and Cole are to become of? He is 50, living at home with his mother, and doesn't have a job, apartment of his own, a pot to piss in, a window to throw it out of, probably not a bank account, a checking account, a savings account, a retirement, a fucking social security fucking income. He probably ain't got shit, let alone a fucking car of his own. You need to ask your mother, what does she really think this relationship is going to become? And then probably 9 times out of 10, she's probably going to think you're in her business. And who are you to ask for that? But in my opinion, I really feel like you need to sit down and talk to your mother and ask her, what does she think this relationship is going to become when she's dating a 50-year-old that's living at home with his fucking mother? His mother is not living with him. He's living with his mother. That looks really weird to me. Like, so he's going to use your mom until the end of the earth. I'm going to be honest and say this. If I could live with my mother right about now and just get by with not paying bills and stuff like that, I would too. I would live with anybody if I could do that. And then use somebody up. If it was logical and if I was that type of person, then I bet I could. But I'm not that type of person. I can't live with anybody and use them. I can't do people like that. But then we have those who are snakes and fucking sleaze buckets that can do that. Trust and believe. I had somebody that did that to me. But at the age of 50, you should have a job. You should have some type of retirement, 401k, something going on like that, right? I'm just saying, you should have something going on for yourself. Does he have any kids? Why isn't he living with his kids? Why isn't his kids helping him out if he has children? Either way, my opinion to you, Natalie, would be to sit down and have a nice chat with your mom and ask her, where does she really think this relationship is going? If they have been in a relationship for so long, why ain't he living with her, helping her out with the bills and shit? I'm sorry, but if we've been in a relationship since you was in like kind of like the second grade, first grade, and you're 21 years old, then I would think that maybe we should be living together and we should be splitting the cost of living and working together as a unity. Not you living at home with your mama. That's like a red flag right there. Oh, you want to live at home with your mama, but you don't want to live with me. Oh, let's see why. Because you don't want to pay for shit. You're a freeloader. You're a scum of the earth. You're a fucking user. I can go on and on with this one, but I'm not. My opinion to you would be, as long as your mom allows it to, yeah, it's going to. Okay? She likes to have the companionship. Some women are like that. However, maybe you should open up her eyes and make her think for herself and let her know, listen, you have this man controlling you. How you gonna control somebody and tell them how to think and what to say and what to do when you ain't even got shit of your own? Like, oh my God. I guess that was the issue with me and a whole old boy that I had to get rid of. Nigga, you ain't about to tell me what to think, do, and say and how I should feel. You ain't even got shit of your own. Get the fuck out of here with that bullshit. Like, man, please. Have a nice chat with your mom and let her know what's on your mind and how you feel about the situation and see what her frame thought is about it. Give her some fucking room to think about shit. Sometimes you have to do that with people. You have to allow them to think for themselves. Give them examples and situations and reasons. And what they will do is they'll think for themselves. If you don't, they're just going to go ahead and be somebody's puppet like Pinocchio. And they're going to be controlled by a fucking man. I'm sorry, but I'm not about to let any man control me, let alone a man that ain't got shit. And at 50 years old, living at home with his mother. That's just not about to happen. Yeah, no. So let's get on to the next one. Leave Natalie your opinions. So, hey now, Diva, I'm coming at you again for some advice. So let's get into it. I've been messing around with my baby daddy on and off for years. And when he went to jail this last time, I cut off all communication with him for about a year. Mind you, I was pregnant during the first year he was there. So when he got out, my baby was about 8 months old or so. But that nigga didn't do shit for my baby. He went back to jail, but kept on calling me, asking me when I will bring her down to visit. That wasn't going to happen. Anyways, he got out again. By now, my baby is 3, okay? He got a job or whatever, but when it came time for my baby's birthday, that bitch didn't even bring my baby nothing, not even a damn doll. But you know what? I didn't even trip. I blocked his ass. But then he left a nasty-ass message and called me all out of my name. He even had his daughter call me and ask, could she see her sister? What the fuck? And he has some stuff to bring her for a month later. Well, to make the long story kind of short, all that disrespected for one outfit. Then on top of it, I found out I was pregnant again and shit. I just been going back and forth with it to see if I'm going to keep it or not. One, I already have 3 kids and I'm doing it alone. My last one and I kept a secret until he went and tried to tell everyone, but he still hasn't told the baby mother that he lives with now. When I told him I was pregnant, he was like, what are you going to keep this a secret too until what, I expose it? I didn't say anything. I just listened a while. In the meantime, I'm thinking that bitch just told on himself. He told me everyone was coming up to him and asking, do you see the type of shit I'm going through? My other kids found out I'm pregnant and they're happy, but I'm on the fence because what I really want to do is pick up my family and move like you did. Sorry this was all over the place, but if you can piece something together, I would really appreciate it. Whoever you want me to be, okay? So we're going to call her Kenya. So Kenya has 3 kids, and she's already doing on her own. Her baby daddy is the one that she's pregnant by again. So she is on baby number 4. And let's see here. She's like, so her baby father lives with somebody else, I take it. And she's like, everybody's coming up to her baby father asking him, is she pregnant? But here's the main thing. Do you see the type of shit I'm going through? Kenya, the type of shit you're going through is the type of shit you're going through because you allow yourself to go through it. You're doing this to your motherfucking self. You wouldn't be going through any of this if you didn't allow somebody like this nigga impregnate you again. If you are having 3 kids and you're doing it on your own, why would you want to get pregnant to somebody else, the same dude again, who doesn't even do anything for you? So what, he's not good enough to bring, he's not good enough to come to your daughter's party, bring her any kind of gifts for her birthday, take care of your kids that he has with you, but he's good enough to fuck. That just totally doesn't make any sense. If you can't bring my daughter nothing, and if you cannot take care of your kids, what makes you think that I'm about to give you any of what's going down in between my legs? I'm thinking my daughter's at the door. She's like, she sometimes slips notes to me under the door. And it sounds like it. But, like, why would you want to have a baby with a knucklehead? Like, I'm sorry, but did we miss something here? Now, yeah, I have 5 kids. Me, April, I have 5 kids to 4 different fathers, okay? And, yeah, I'm not going to stick around. If the first one acts stupid, I'm not going to have another baby with them again. And so on and so on. So, yeah, I had 2 kids with somebody, and that was my husband. But you think I would have a third one with him? And I'm sorry, but times are hard, and should you pick up your family and move on? Sweetheart, I think you should have been moved on, okay? So now you've got this knucklehead, and he has a baby mama who he lives with, and he's going to expose you. So what's up with his baby mother that he's living with? Is it okay with her that he impregnates other women and still lives at home with her? I wish a nigga would tell me that, oh, I got my baby mother pregnant again, but we together. Where is that happening at? So the shit that you're going through is the shit, Kenya, that you put your own self through. You didn't get pregnant alone. He didn't come in the middle of the night like some type of miracle baby and just pop a seed in your belly. You laid down, opened your legs for him, and allowed him to fuck you and impregnate you. But you didn't allow him to take care of his kids. And even if you did allow him, he didn't do it anyway. Okay, he did not do that. And if you don't take care of your kids, what the fuck or why the fuck would I allow you to get me pregnant again? Yeah, I know a lot of you bitches are probably like, damn, April, you coming kind of strong. But I'm just saying, reality check. I don't really feel sorry for anybody that has already gone through the dumb shit several times. And then you allow yourself to go through it again. Like, I don't really feel sorry for anybody like that. Because for the simple fact is, if you already seen the shit was sour, and then it got molded, and then fucking got rancid, why the fuck would you allow this shit to happen again with the same fucking jackass? Like, really? On some real shit. And I'm not being just fucking harsh because of my breakup. It's just because I've been through enough bullshit in my life that I'm just not going to allow the same dumb shit. That's why I got rid of the last motherfucker that I just left, because I don't allow that shit. Once I see some shit, nigga, you out. Like, I'm not fucking with you. And if I have to be alone for the rest of my motherfucking life, then so be it. At least I'll have the sanity and I won't be fucking going crazy. So, Kenya, the shit that you're going through is on you. That's the shit that you allow. Why wouldn't you take that nigga to child support, get him to take care of his fucking kids, and do what the fuck he's supposed to do instead of laying down and making another baby with him? That just doesn't make any kind of sense to me. And, okay, so you have three kids and you're doing it alone. Okay, so what? You're going to have four kids and you're going to do it alone again? You can. You can do it alone. I've had five and I've done it alone. That just makes me a stronger and more wiser person. And hopefully after the fourth kid, you are more stronger and wiser and don't allow knuckleheads like this motherfucker, baby daddy, who keep getting in and out of jail, to fuck with you. You have to put yourself on a pedestal and on a level to where certain motherfuckers are not worthy of you. If you feel like no men are worthy of you, then that may allow you to attract the certain type of man that is right for you. But if you keep going back to scum, you're going to keep getting scum, and it's not going to work out for you. You know what I'm saying? And that's just what happens. Some people say, oh, step outside of the box and date somebody else on a different racial ethnicity. Just because they're a different race does not fucking mean that they're not going to be an asshole, okay? It doesn't matter. Chinese, black, Spanish, whatever. They're all assholes. Each fucking race has an asshole to it. Regardless. Why don't women just search their soul and find themselves? Get on your feet. Work on you. Work on taking care of your kids. Some women find it so fucking hard to just settle down, meaning hunker down and take care of your fucking responsibilities and your children and yourself and better your lives. Some women find it so hard, they feel like they need a man to do that. You don't need a man to do that if you don't have one, okay? When you're vulnerable like that, you attract the wrong fucking man, all right? So in my opinion, hunker down. Educate your children. Spend time with them and educate them and teach them the values of life. So that way they're not out there shooting and gang banging and selling drugs and weed on the corner and fucking up in school. That's why there's kids these days, and it doesn't matter what race they are. They have these mothers that don't really give a fuck about them because they're so busy trying to find a relationship and find who they are. And the kids are not being paid attention to when they fucking up. And then there are kids that come from really good homes that fuck up too. But I'm just saying, know your kids' value and know your value. Know your worth. Then that way you won't have to be in these type of predicaments. You know what I'm saying? So don't sit here and tell me, oh, the shit that you're going through. Because I really don't feel sorry for you. This is the second email that you sent me. And you've already been through this. Fucking wisen up. Wisen the fuck up and get it together. bottom line. So divas, I really want to make that the last one because that's the third one. And of course I have barbecuing to do. I'm going to make some lobster tails on the barbecue with my kids and my daughter Tati. She's making some baked macaroni and cheese with shrimp in it, and it tastes so good. Oh my god. And I'm going to make some sausage, some Italian sausage, and some lobster tails, and Tati's going to make some empanadas. So it is 5:23 in the afternoon or the evening, and I really, really, really need to get going with the lobster tails. So I hope you enjoyed Real Talk. Leave your comments below for that, and of course I will see you guys next Wednesday on Real Talk. But in the meantime, in between time, make sure you check out my other videos for makeup, hair, and I don't know, hauls. Yeah, hauls. Cheapskate hauls, because I'm cheap bitch. But other than that, thanks for staying tuned, and I'll see you girls and guys on my next video.